Hey there, Mavericks. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your Gusto payroll account. Gusto is really easy to use, which is one of the great perks of this software. And they have a really clear instructions for how to set up your account. So it's pretty simple. You are going to need some documentation to get started, including your business tax information, as well as information from your employees, both their personal information and their tax information as well. So you can take a break and go gather that, or keep watching the video and see exactly what you need as we make this as simple as possible. So when you log into your Gusto account for the first time, you're going to be taken to this welcome screen, and they are going to want some information from you to set up your account. So the first question they're going to ask is who you're planning to pay. So you'll select everything that's applicable to your business. So you can click myself, you can click employees if you have and this would be U.S.-based employees, people who have W-2 forms. Then you can select domestic contractors, and you can even select international contractors as well. The way you'll know the difference is one will have 1099s. Those will be U.S. contractors. International contractors will have W-8 forms. So there's a little bit of a difference when it comes to tax season, so you want to make sure you select the proper selection. If at any time you add a type of employee that we didn't select in this menu, you'll be able to update that. So you'll want to select what's applicable to your business first. There's also this option for if you're not planning on paying anyone for at least 3 months, you can click that. So say you're just getting your payroll up and running, you're not paying employees yet, or you're taking your time transferring from your old software, whatever the case might be, you can select that if you're not ready to add employees. Click continue. And then next, you will put whichever date is your first payday that you want to use Gusto for. So let's say you're going to then select if this is the first payday of the whole year for your business, or if you've previously been paying people but are just switching over to Gusto, then you would click no. And then you would be prompted to select your current provider, whichever one you're coming over for, whether you're switching from ADP, Paychex, QuickBooks, or something else. This will help Gusto be able to have you migrate your information over once we get to that point. So it's important to select the correct one. If you haven't been using a payroll software yet, and this is your first time using payroll software, first of all, congratulations. Payroll software is awesome. I think you're going to be pleasantly surprised by Gusto and how it automates a lot of things. But if you fall into that category, you'll just click this. We don't have a payroll provider that we're switching from. We've been running it manually. So you'll click that option and then you'll click continue. And then now you'll get a little notification that says your customized setup experience is ready, and you'll click let's go. These next steps really are going to be customized to whatever selections you made on the last screen. So if these next steps don't look exactly like what you are seeing, it's because you had different selections. So you might be asked to manually upload some of your previous payroll statements. You might be asked to add a certain type of employee that we didn't select for this video. So if it's a little bit different, that's why. But we're still going to go through and just show you the gist of how to set things up. The actual navigation and user interface of the software is going to be the same. And Gusto is also really good at explaining the steps. So once you're ready, you're going to click let's go. And that's going to start loading. You'll see that little Gusto piggy bank. You'll get really used to that one. So next, you are going to add your filing address. And it will likely automatically populate it. And then you can add your phone number as well. Then you're going to select if any of your W-2 employees work at this location or if it's fully a remote location. So if it's just a mailing address, you'll select this one. If it's a physical location where people work, you'll select that one. Continue. And then it may update your filing address's format. So just make sure that that is correct. And then it's also going to ask if they need to send you physical mail, if that's the address they should send it to. So in this case, physical mail is fine at that one. If you have a PO box or something and you don't want physical mail at the address that your business is registered, you'd click this, use a different address, I'm going to add that in. Click save and continue. And then next, you would need to add all of your physical work addresses. This can be a little bit tedious if you have a lot of remote employees because you're going to have to add all of their addresses. So buckle down, get yourself a cup of coffee if you have a lot of remote employees. If you don't, if you all work at an office, you are in luck and you can just click this. I've added all my addresses. Once you've added all the addresses in, you're going to click next. Okay, they're requiring at least one physical address. And then next, if you have an accountant or a bookkeeper, you can add their information here. So you can click, yes, I have an external accountant or an external bookkeeping service. You'll add their name and their contact information. Gusto's going to sync with them directly, which is really easy on you. So you'll select if you have an external one, or if you have an in-house accountant or bookkeeper, or if you select no, you don't. It does give you the option where you can find a partner of Gusto's for an accountant. If you need any help figuring out how to find a good accountant, we have a great post on that here at Merchant Maverick. And we also have a lot of really great accounting software content. If you're wanting to handle a small business accounting all by yourself, we've got you covered. So choose whichever selection is right for your business and then click save and continue. So for the Plaid verification, you're going to click verify account with Plaid, and then you're going to collect this continue. This is a little disclaimer about how Gusto uses Plaid to connect to your bank account. Then you're going to select your bank institution. Once you do that, you'll have to put in your online credentials for logging into your bank account. So as if you were logging into your online bank, you're going to enter that here. Then Gusto will, through Plaid, automatically connect Gusto to your bank account and sync the two up so that you can start paying your employees directly from your bank account. And once you do that, you'll be set up for that so you can start paying your employees. Once you add your information, you'll see this little success screen pop up to let you know that your bank has successfully been connected to Gusto. Then you're going to click continue. You will then be taken to a screen that shows your business bank account information. And if that information looks correct, you're going to click continue. After that, you're going to be asked to set up your federal tax information. And so you'll need to enter your EIN as well as your business entity type. Next, you'll have to select your filing form. If you have a 941, that means you file taxes every quarter. If you have a form 944, that means you file them annually. You'll want to select which is appropriate for your business. If you're not sure, you can talk to your accountant about this or read some documentation on Gusto's site about the difference, and I'll help you select the proper one. Next, you'll be asked to enter what industry your business is in. You can search by a code. So say you're a farming business. It will pop up all of the different options and you can select the one that is appropriate. If you by chance are a cannabis related business, then you'll need to select this as there are really specific regulations that Gusto has to go through in order to process your payroll. And then if for some reason your industry isn't listed there, you can select this option. And then once you are done with those selections, you'll click this save and continue button. Since this is just a demo account for this video, I'll just walk you through verbally through the next steps as we would need an actual EIN to finish this next bit. But there are only two steps left in setting up your Gusto account. The first will be adding your information about your benefits that you offer your employees. So Gusto makes it really easy to offer benefits to your employees if you haven't set this up yet. If you already have companies you work with, this is where you'll be able to enter. You'll select which benefits apply to your business. Then after that, you're going to start adding the general information that you expect. So you'll have to add your employees, your pay schedule, your state tax details. This will be the different tax percentages that you are required to pay by your state. Again, if you don't know what those are, this is a great time to talk to your accountant. And then you can also at this point enter any historical payroll information that you have. You'll want to make sure that both with your employee information and your historical information, that you have full employee names on hand, as well as your employees' filing statuses, their withholding, everything on their W-4s. And then you also will need their social security numbers if they are US W-2 employees. And then for your historical payroll information, you might also want old pay stubs and old pay records. This is a time where you can manually enter those in. You can also upload them if you are using an existing software. And then you're going to be asked to sign a couple of documents, add your workers' comp insurance if you have it. If you don't, Gusto will hook you up with a partner. If you're not sure if you need workers' comp insurance, we have some great content here at Merchant Maverick on what workers' comp is, what it covers, and when it's needed. Hint, you need it in 49 of the 50 US states. And then after that, you're going to just keep clicking that green save and continue button. And that's the last step. After that, you've set up your Gusto account and you can start running your payroll. Keep coming back to Merchant Maverick to help make your small business easy and for all of your payroll needs, and have a great day.